Well, this is what I was excited for. Our next guest's dream is to become an astrophysicist. He's taken the steps toward that dream. He has finished high school in under 3 years with a 4.0 GPA and has already finished a semester of college. Here's the kicker, though, okay? He's 9. That is him. In addition to becoming one of the youngest high school graduates in the country, David Balogun is a member of Mensa, of course. David and his parents, Rania and Henry, join us now. Oh, my goodness.
Morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Hey, David, how's college?
Good.
What was it like graduating from high school at 9?
Well, everybody started talking about how this is an incredible accomplishment, and I was thinking how all I did is graduate. And then my mom saying, you graduated at the age of 9, and then I say, yeah, I graduated, what's the big deal? You graduated at the age of 9. So what is the big deal?
So what is the big deal? Do you know what the big deal is? Or is this just normal to you? Like, you know?
It just comes. You just, for me, you just do it.
Yeah. So mom and dad, what did you do? Because every parent watching is going to be like, well, wait a minute. What did they do and what am I doing wrong? So did you do anything special, you think, or different that puts David ahead of the pack?
I think you just have to listen to your child and get outside of the box. He was the one that leading the charge. He's the one that was motivated. I just had to break out of the box and think outside of the normal schooling, think outside of what people know and what I know growing up, and just give him chance to be and do what he's dreaming to be and do.
Well, what do you mean by that?
Because people are going to say, like, what specifically?
Sorry, go ahead, Dad.
Go ahead, Ed.
In addition to that, there are so many factors that we saw very early when David was growing up. And he is the type that is very curious about everything. And everywhere we went, he always asked, what is this? What is that? And then if you explain and you use big words, he will want you to break it down and tell me, what does that mean? And when he comes with me to my clinic, I have an outpatient psychiatric clinic. When he comes to me, to the clinic, he always asks questions. Why do you do this as opposed to doing that? And what does this mean instead of, you know, and you have to explain without explaining, if you know what I mean, because you still have to pay attention to the requirements of the law. We keep patient information highly confidential because of the HIPAA law. And so, I still have to break it down for him. I never said to him, shut up.
Yeah.
Or go and do something else. No, I will take the time to break things down.
Dad, I'm going to just make this point with Poppy, because Poppy and I were talking about it, and you as well, when talking about when I was a kid, my mom would, like, pull me back. I'd go talk to people.
Yeah.
And my dad would say, don't make him afraid of people. Yep. Let him be curious. And you do the same thing with your kids.
I do.
Don't tell them no.
I try to say we can't do that now, but what else could we do?
Right.
Present options. Hey, David, what do you want to be when you grow up, David?
Well, there are a few things that I want to be. An astrophysicist, an engineer, a nuclear chemist, a software developer, a rocket engineer, and
A website. Nothing like it. Well, I was going to say ball player. That would be great, too, right? He has all kinds of skills. I'm sure he can do it. Hey, David and Mom and Dad, we have a surprise for you. Okay, are you ready? One of the world's most famous scientists wants to say hi to you. Astrophysicist Neil DeGrasse Tyson is here with us. Hi, Neil. Good morning.
Hey, are you serious?
Hey, everybody. Hey. Hey, David.
Good morning.
Hey, how are you?
Yeah. Hey, David, I was 9 when I decided I wanted to be an astrophysicist, except I was still in 4th grade, okay? So, just in case you didn't know this, it is unusual to be entering college at that grade. But the greatest value to knowing this early, what you might want to do, looks like you're giving yourself a few options there, and that's great. The greatest value is you can align decisions related to your life to feed that interest and curiosity, so that by the time you become a professional in that world, your whole life has been invested on that path. And then you'll become better at that than you would anything else you can imagine. So I'm especially intrigued that you know what you want to be when you grow up, but you're kind of already grown up, so I don't even know what that means.
David, is there anything you want to say to the great Neil deGrasse Tyson before we gotta go?
Well, we are really blessed to have you talk to David. I mean, he has read so much about you and heard so much about you. And every time he sees you on the TV and doing something somewhere, he's always impressed.
Well, Dad, let him talk about it.
And to talk to you.
Let him talk about it, Dad.
Talk about your theory. Go ahead.
How do you feel?
My theory?
Yes. Go ahead.
How do you feel?
So I was in my Earth and Science high school class, and I created a theory to refute the Big Bang theory. So
we love new ideas.
The main thanks.
Hey, go on.
So the main part of the theory is that matter cannot be created or destroyed. According to the Big Bang theory, the little, I guess you'll call it, ball cosmic egg, something like that. It was infinitely dense. Now, in order for it to be infinitely dense, it has to be constantly creating matter.
Oh my gosh.
Wow.
But in order for it to constantly be creating matter, it would have to violate the laws of physics. And since we're technically talking about the universe, not all the space outside of the universe, then the laws of physics should still apply.
Okay, so wait, Neil, is he... Hang on 1 second, because we have to go. I'm sorry, David, because we're just out of time. I don't mean to be disrespectful to a 9-year-old graduated college and is explaining that how he refuted this. Neil, is he schooling you right now? But we got to run.
So we love new ideas that challenge our previous ideas. So in the end, David, what you have to do is come up with a way to test your idea. Yeah. Then we can then hand it over to people with telescopes and space probes and this sort of thing. And then we can see if your new hypothesis about the universe is correct. Right. That's how we do that. That's how we roll on the frontier. Science.
This we roll. We have time. We have to deal with time issues here and get to breaks and pay the bills. We're so happy to have all of you on. David, best of luck to you, Mom and Dad as well. Neil, thank you. It was very kind of you to come on.
Very kind of you, Neil. My day has been made. Yeah. Go ahead, Neil.
My podcast is coming to the Keswick Theater in Pennsylvania at the end, in outside of Philly, at the end of March. So be delighted to offer your family some tickets for that.
Well, that would be great.
That would be amazing. Yeah. Thank you very much.
We'd love to meet all of you in person, have you all come on the set. David, keep us abreast of what you're doing. Good luck. Keep killing it. Thanks.
Have fun. Right. Yes, have fun, too. Thank you.
Don't forget to be a kid, right?
Yeah, have fun, too.